Banes from XFM Iloilo. I have some clarifications. What's the right term for us to use? Is rectification or another one is rehabilitation for accuracy's sake? Number two, what shall we do with the affected niya peers once mag-commence na rectification or rehabilitation? Number three, ingalitan ko lang niya kayo sa loob ng questioning. Number three, anong system sa DPWH sa implementation of projects? Pag-download sa program plans or designs, walang sa power to review and give feedback sa national, for example, kung sa national hindi naghalin niya ng design that somehow you have a concern. Example, the nearest structure with the board piling of around 48 to 52 meters just beside Iloilo Supermart and a small bridge or titan. Pero kanton niya flyover is only 28 meters. Why hindi man notice there is a region that we have a concern on a specific portion sa aton niya ng project? And fourth, lumusot ko lang, sir. Fourth, gidget grouting naton ang the rest of the columns. Why? Do we have also concerns with the rest of the columns? Because gidget grouting naton. And we have high concerns sa columns 4, 5, and 6. Thank you.
Well, tagi siya isa ang taan, sir, no? So, kindly state, please, again, the number 1, ay kay IQE at siya ng tatiritso. Then we will proceed to number 2, 3, and 4. Pwede mo malaliwan?
Yes, sir. Question number 1, anong correct and the appropriate and the accurate term to be used? It's rectification or rehabilitation?
Well, actually, for me, it is a rectification. Because strengthening or rehabilitation, wala, pag-audit siya eh. Yung project, so hindi natin pwede ma-rehab. So, rectification because of the observation, to correct the observation and the pitch being observed sa atong structure.
And number two, sir, is what will happen to PS 3, 4, 4, 5, and 6 if mag-commence na rectification, which is putangan natin sa board pile at palibot sa main column?
Based on the study, and of course, on the soil investigation made by the third-party consultant, Engineer Adam Abinales, ang iyang recommendation that the existing PL 4, 5, and 6 will be supported by additional 4 board pile sa tupad sa existing column with an additional length of 47 meters, sorry. Pama na siya ang iyong recommendation. His recommendation was primarily based on the observation and findings sa iyong soil exploration. So, ginbasihan niya. The rest of the pier is only an intense jet grouting. Because ang nakita niya na nalubok, but basically, ang ginarecommenda niya na intense jet grouting is still a scientific rectification in order to provide us na wala sa additional movement na magpakita sa near future.
Okay. Ang next sinasabi is ang surface ibabaw, it will be removed?
As I said a while ago, that span 4 to 5, span 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and 6 to 7 will be basically removed.
Okay.
And para na may construction area ka sa atong mga equipment.
As a system manager sa DPWH, we do understand nga may sistema ng DPWH as far as implementation of projects. Let's say for example, this project imanage sa Manila. So, in-download there is a region for implementation. We do understand we have seasoned engineers, project engineers, etc. here. Happens to be retirable na most of them. Implementing projects. may ngalan na na eh, kada taytay kay Engineer Amon eh, sa kasada kay Engineer Amon eh, yung supervisor, project engineers, or even site engineers. Pag-abot rin, wala ini, anong sistema, gina-review ini the result. For example, ang natabo direct sa flyover, 28 ang lubong, based on soil test conducted by UTCP. But ang yield structure, what happens to be, itay-tay going to Tangas. Ang board piling, if I'm not mistaken, is 48 to 52 meters deep. So, noticing that, from the site engineer to the project engineer, seeing the program design, wala ginabis ang feedback na, oops, we have a concern. Not a problem pa, but we have a concern here. Can we give feedback to the Bureau of Design and to the DPWH National Office? So, may sistema na, sir. Katulad sila. Thank you.
Well, actually, ang ako na mahambal sa inyo, nga every time we design a structure, we need to have the soil exploration. Even if the soil exploration, the drilling of the soil exploration, may distansya lang na 5 meters, it varies the soil formation. So every time that we have a structure, kahit kinanan natin. Even if we are designing our Portland cement concrete pavement, it needs a soil exploration. So that is why all data presented by the commission consultant in a base Manila sa Ilanga, Umbra. So what the regional office did sang ipadala diri ang plano in mabili kagin implement. So we all just believe that the product or the result of the detailed engineering conducted by UTCP, eksakto gin-implement natin. However, the pigs were just observed during the opening. And because of the safety of the commuters, ang ito naging close natin.
So, next is system, yeah, sir. The read down below, sa region, for example, sa district.
Sa kinasiling ko na, gin-presentar sa ato ang plano, kaya muna ang gin-start natin implement.
Okay, so wala na sa feedback.
We don't have the authority to question the integrity of the design submitted by the commission consultant.
Hello, lulubusin ko na po tatlong questions po para maka-exit na rin po ko sa mind. First question, why do we have to wait for public opinion or the opinion of the media on this? Does the DPWH not have expertise to be able to determine when and how to reopen the UPAC flyover? Number two question, sir. Isa-isa na natin para maka-exit na rin ako, sir. Number two question, in the past few weeks, may buhok na nakita nito sa Italon sa flyover to be able to identify it and what did it do about it. Third, what would be the bidding process for the rectification? Will the International Builders Corporation be allowed to also bid on this project? Answer.
Number one. Iklarohon ko niya para I can directly address all concerns.
Number one, sir. Bakit pa natin kailangan maghintay for public opinion or inputs from the media?
Well, actually, we are not seeking public opinion as far as opening is concerned. We are just seeking understanding from the public that once we will open this, it